Welcome to Half Moon Tech Labs. Today we're going to talk about office chairs and gaming chairs and how to change the pneumatic lift cylinder that you find in almost all these that ends up failing eventually. Okay, this one's bottomed right out. Now, it seems to be adjustable. I can go up. I can adjust it. Goes down. Appears to be okay. But actually, if you leave it or if you just sit in it for long enough, it just lowers itself down and ends up on the bottom, or if it just sits there for long enough, it'll be on the bottom. So when you go to sit in it, you're going to see, you're going to get that, and then you're going to adjust it, and then it's slowly going to go down over the course of the day, and it's going to drive you slowly mad. Anyway, if your chair is in otherwise good condition, there's an easy way to change just the cylinder, just the pneumatic lift cylinder itself on these chairs. They're fairly generic. They're fairly standardized. The diameter of them is fairly standardized. The length and the stroke of the piston itself is what varies from chair to chair. Luckily, it's easy enough to measure it. You can go on Amazon and you can buy a pneumatic cylinder replacement kit, just like this, that has a cylinder. It has the special tools to remove your old cylinder. It even comes, this particular one. This particular one came with a set of gloves. Give you a little better grip and keep your hands clean. Yay. All right, so let's get into it. Let's change the cylinder on this chair. I'll show you how it's done. I thought real quick I'd give you another look at this kit. So this particular kit comes with a cylinder. Like I said, these are the diameter is fairly standardized. These are around 1.9 to 2 inches US measure. The in metric, it's gonna be around 50 millimeters nominally, give or take a few millimeters. Don't get hung up on that because there is a slight taper to this. It will find its spot in your chair and it's fine. So just find something that's very close. It doesn't have to be exact. It just needs to be in the ballpark for these tapered ones. The part that's the variable on these that is really different from chair to chair is the overall length of the cylinder. And if you press this button, that's the extended stroke length. You want to have this measurement and you want to have this measurement. And you want to know roughly how far it goes up and down. You can press these buttons. It takes a lot to compress them, but watch. You can get it down a little bit. You can also kind of see some of the wear marks on the old one when you pull it out. You'll be able to figure it out and then go online and you can find the replacement kit. This kit was nice because for a couple extra dollars, this one was closer to $30, but still less than 30 bucks for a cylinder, an Allen wrench, and they even threw in a pair of gloves. There's a set of jacking screws and clamps that you use to remove the old one. Let me show you how that works because this is really cool and it makes the job super easy. So I'm gonna put the old chair up here upside down. We'll see how that works and see if I can get the other cylinder off and get some good shots of how to use this to remove the old cylinder. And then putting the new one in is a snap. Here we go. All right, one of the first things you want to do is raise the chair. Now it's upside down, so I'm going to push this and it's going to go up in this case. There we go. And that's so that we can get to the cylinder. I'm just going to do, you can use a piece of tape or something for this if you want, but I just don't feel like fighting these little collapsible plastic guards. So what we want to do is we want to take this piece first, this little clamshell assembly here. I'm going to take my Allen key and put this on. This I'm going to put on the bottom, flush to the part that the cylinder is going through. So you just go all the way down. And I'm just going to go snug with that. It doesn't have to be crazy. And that's because it's going to be pushing against this piece, which is pushing against this piece. So this doesn't have to be super tight. It just has to just be snug, that's all. It's actually better not to tighten this up entirely. Then you do the same thing with this one. Only this has these what are called jacking screws. So you wanna back those screws out so that they are no longer just, you know, just a little less in flush is perfect. See that? And then we're gonna open this up again. And we're simply going to set this on top of the other one. and do the same thing. Tighten these up. In this case, we're going to get these fairly tight to start with here. Okay, and you want to make sure it's flat against this one entirely. Now you really want to tighten it up. Get it real tight. Its job is to grab this bar, the cylinder, by its outside without scarring it. And then these screws are going to push down on this and they're going to jack the cylinder out of the hole here. That way we don't destroy the place that the new cylinder is going to be mounted. And it gives you a way to get the other one out fairly easily. So just tighten this one on top up a lot. And really, really tighten that one down. Okay. Now that those are good and snug, the idea is this can't slip on this rod. This one here is just pushing against the bottom. Now we go and we tighten up these jacking screws. I'm just going to go down until I can't turn it anymore. There we go. Now, just go back and forth across these two screws. Try to be even. Go the same amount. It's not the end of the world if it you get ahead a little bit on one. Just kind of keep eyeballing it. Now, in theory, what we're doing is by pushing pressure down on this, we're slowly, eventually, we'll overcome the force that's holding that cylinder in. But it could take a little while. See how we've got a little bit of a gap here? Keep going. Eventually, you'll feel it get loose. When that happens, there we go. There. It's free. Now the old one's out. So let's, now I'm simply going to take this and remove it. All right, we're going to remove these clamps. Okay, we're going to save these for the next chair we have to do. Don't throw those away. All right. Pull off all these feet so I don't have to battle with them. And now we just want to tap this cylinder out of that hole. And for that, I'm just going to grab this ball peen hammer. We don't care about the cylinder now, but we don't want to break anything. I'm just gonna tap around here until it falls out. There it goes. Now that hole is free. I pulled these wheels off just to make it easy. They just snap right back in. You don't have to pull them off, but anyway, this guy just drops right down into the hole, like so. That's it. But don't forget, when you're done, drop that down inside the base. Put your thing back on. Take a chair. Drop the seat pan down on top of the cylinder. Nothing fancy. Okay, mission accomplished. That worked. So for $20 and change, you can do this yourself instead of spending a couple hundred dollars or more on a good office or a real expensive gaming chair. They can get crazy expensive. They all have the same cylinder, essentially. The only thing that difference is the stroke length. So if you find find the size of yours, you can buy the kit to replace it yourself. It takes a matter of minutes, which you just saw, and that's it. You just breathe new life into an old office or gaming chair to save a ton of money. $20 beats spending a few hundred dollars, hands down. So anyway, that's how you do it. Hopefully this helps. Hope you enjoyed it. And thanks for tuning in to Half Moon Tech Labs. We'll see you.